next 18 minutes, I'd like to share with you my Bollywood journey. So I'd like to share with you a little bit about my work as a Bollywood journalist. I'll also add a little bit of Bollywood acting, some Bollywood dancing, and a little bit of Bollywood massage. I'm going to start by asking a question. How many of you are engineers? If you can raise your hands if you're studying engineering. Quite a lot of you, lots of BTEC students. I know that in India, it's very popular to study engineering. I think it's the type of subject that we study because all of our friends around us are also doing engineering. In my country, in the UK, it's the same thing, but with English. So when you kind of don't know what you want to do and you can't really think about what to study, everyone thinks, I know, I'll study English. So when I did my first degree, that's exactly what I did. Then I came to live in India for a couple of years. And I think living in India, I was really inspired by Bollywood. So when I went back to London to do my postgraduate studies, I decided not to do English, now that was boring. I thought, let me study my master's in Bollywood. And that's exactly what we did, doing a master's in Indian cinema from SOAS, the School of Oriental and African Studies. It was while I was living in London that I decided I really wanted to become a Bollywood journalist. And I started writing for one of the UK's national newspapers. I also had a column with the Hindustan Times. And I wrote over 5,000 Bollywood articles for one of the UK's leading entertainment websites. How many of you like Bollywood? A show of hands. How many of you love Bollywood? Good. All right, there's lots we can talk about. I'm sure we can speak for the rest of the event all about Bollywood, Bollywood, Bollywood. But I'd like to just focus in on one aspect of my work, and that's Bollywood interviews. So I'd like to share with you some snippets, some interactions that I've had with some of the biggest Bollywood actors and stars in the industry. Let's begin with this person. Who am I sitting next to? Yes, so I met Deepika Padukone when she came over to London to promote one of her films. It wasn't Om Shanti Om, it wasn't Cocktail, it was a lesser known film, in fact probably one of her few flop films. It was called Drink Killer. Has anybody seen this movie? One person said yes. So I thought that I would try to impress Deepika with my Hindi skills. I was learning Hindi at the time. So when Deepika came into the room, I said, Namaste, Deepika. Mera naam Steven hai. Mera kaam ek aadmi tha. And Deepika said to me, sorry, I don't really speak much Hindi. I'm from South India. I'm from Bangalore. So all of my attempts at trying to impress Deepika failed miserably. But she's a very sweet person, and as sweet in real life as she is on screen. Do you recognize this person?
Very well.
Who is it? Absolutely. You can see this picture. It's not a recent picture. The picture was right at the start of her career. So you can see that both I and Anushka Sharma look quite different today. In this picture, it was taken while she was shooting for a film. The film was called Patiala House. Has anybody seen that movie?
Yes.
Okay, what's the theme of the movie? What story is it all about? Absolutely. So we actually did the interview in a cricket stadium in Nottingham in the UK. And I think maybe that's where Anushka's first interest in cricket developed. standing on the right of me? And who's standing on the left? So this was doing promotions for a film. You see the poster behind, do you recognize the movie? Absolutely. And in this moment in time, we were having our picture taken at the end of the interview. As well as doing Bollywood journalism, I've also acted in over 20 Bollywood films. You're probably thinking, but I don't recognize it. That's because I've had very small parts in Bollywood films. I'm sure you've all seen those European people standing in the background holding drinks, all vaguely dancing into Bollywood films, quite far behind the leading actors. So I've done lots of that work as part of my research for my dissertation at SOAS. When I was having a picture taken, I was talking to Ashwari Rai about how I've recently been shooting with her husband on a film called Vastana, and we were laughing and joking about that just as the picture was clicked, which is why you see my eyes are half closed. And Ashwari Rai has a strange expression as if she's been caught mid-conversation. The only person being professional and posing for the camera properly is critic. You all recognize this wonderful gentleman. I have the great privilege of interviewing Mr. Yash Chopra for a radio show in London. It was a wonderful 30-minute radio show where Yash Chopra came to the UK to receive an honorary degree from the University of London. Yash Chopra, as you know, is a wonderful filmmaker, and I'm sure many of you have grown up on his cinema. So it was a great, great honor to interview him. And as a result of the interview, I was pleased to say that he gave me a small part in his very last film, Jab Jab Hai Jab. One thing I learned from having your picture taken with Abhishek Bachchan is that you should never do it standing up. You should always sit down so the height difference isn't so evident to everyone who sees your picture in the newspaper. Abhishek Bachchan is always in London. I've met him countless times when he would come over for film promotions, red carpet events, lots of things like that. But my favorite interaction with Abhishek Bachchan was, believe it or not, at an acting workshop. And I know that in India, social media, especially Twitter, often says quite negative things about Abhishek Bachchan's acting. But I can say from this workshop, he was brilliant. He was absolutely incredible. What he showed us was about how he changed his voice, how he changed his physicality and his body language for each of the characters that he plays. So he left all of us suitably impressed. And now if anyone says anything negative about his acting skills, I can always talk about how amazing that experience was on the acting workshop. This gentleman, one of Indian cinema's most successful actors. When you think of Amir Khan, we always think of him as being Mr. Perfectionist. Am I right?
Yes.
We always have that association with him. And I got to see this perfectionist level of Amir Khan at first hand when I interviewed him. Because the newspaper that I was working for had asked on Twitter for people to send in their questions to ask this famous Bollywood actor. So as you can imagine, we have lots of questions coming in. And my newspaper had said to me, please get a photograph of Amir Khan
with the laptop, showing the Twitter questions being sent to him. So I asked Mr. Khan if he could do that, and he agreed to take the picture. What he then proceeded to do was spend the next 5 minutes adjusting the screen of the laptop to the exact position so the light of the flash wouldn't get caught and reflect back from the screen. So I realized then, with that eye for detail and that level of perfectionism, why it takes 2 years to release a film. You're probably looking at this picture and thinking, the quality isn't so good. And there's a reason for that. This was at the end of an 8-day shoot with Shah Rukh Khan. And throughout the whole of the 8 days, everybody wanted pictures with Shah Rukh Khan, everybody, but the security guard would block people and say, we'll take pictures on the last day of the shoot. So everyone thought, okay, I'll wait. And on the final day, just as we packed up and we finished shooting for the day, I saw Shah Rukh Khan leaving. And I thought, now is my opportunity to get a picture with him. So I walked out, I posed quickly for the picture, which was taken by this and was obviously a little bit blurry and not such great quality. Then I came back into the set and I said to everyone, look at my phone, look everybody, I've got a picture with Shah Rukh Khan. And nobody was happy. Nobody said, great, well done, that's excellent. People burst into tears. People said, he's gone, he's left. He promised us a picture on the last day of the shoot and now we haven't got it and we've wasted our whole week here. So I was the only person out of about 200 people on that set to get a photograph. And even though the quality isn't great, it's something that I do treasure because everybody in Bollywood wants to work with King Khan. You will recognize this concept. Sitting in the background. Who is that gentleman? Yes, absolutely. So Akshay Kumar, the Dreamy League, the Farah Khan all came to the UK to promote one of the biggest hits of Bollywood cinema. Jeez, Ma, come on. But what happens is when they come to London, you spend the whole day with the cast and the crew, and then they take you to the cinema and you're sitting in these wonderful, expensive seats. And they're giving you free popcorn and they're giving you alcohol. So you go home that night and you find the best 4 or 5 star review ever of Tisma. And in the UK, the films come out the day before they do in India. So you get to watch the film on the Thursday before it opens the next day in India. So all of the UK journalists were biting, this is the best film since Sholay. This is the best film since Rukmiyazama. And then, of course, the next day, everybody watched the film in India and realized that we had been tempted by all of the free cinema gifts and all of the free food and the popcorn and meeting the actors. Has anyone seen the film? Is it the greatest film in Indian cinema? I didn't think so. This picture was taken when I met this gentleman. What is his name? Anil Kapoor. And it's actually the second time I've met him. Originally, I met him in Bombay, shooting on a film called Humko Deewana Kage. Does anybody remember when that film released? Yeah, I guess it was probably about 10 years ago. And then I saw Anil Kapoor after 9 or 10 years, and the amazing thing was he looked younger now than he did a decade ago. I don't know what his secret is, but he must have the fabric on the interview because he looked absolutely incredible. One thing I noticed as well is that in all of the pictures with him, he doesn't take his sunglasses off. In this picture, you can see I'm notably absent. I was behind the camera. And this is when I was interviewing Critic Sitter, who was coming over to London again to receive an honorary degree. Lots of Bollywood actors get honorary degrees from universities in the UK. And on the same day that I was interviewing Critic Sitter in person at the University of East London, I also happened to have a telephone interview with Abhishek Bachchan in Bombay. So I said to one of my friends who was from the hall, his name was Ali, I said, Ali, I know that you live on the campus, and I know that you're staying in one of the hostels. Can I come to your room in about an hour? Because I need quiet space to do my telephone interview with Abhishek Bachchan. So he said, okay, fine. I went to his room, I knocked on the door, I went in, and I saw him frantically tidying in the room, and he was making chai, and he ordered snacks into the room, and I thought, wow, he's going to a lot of trouble. It's just me. And I walked in, and he said, where is Abhishek Bachchan? I said, he's not coming to your room. It's a phone interview. And I think because Priti Zinta just happened to be on his campus that day, he thought that it was an everyday occurrence that Bollywood actors would be walking around his university in London. The last image I'd like to show you today is from a film that I did, which was called Dostana, which came out a few years ago. There's been lots and lots I can talk about on Bollywood. Today it's all been about Bollywood journalism, so I will save Bollywood acting for another day. If you would like to connect with me, please find me on Twitter. You can see this is my Twitter handle here. Thank you so much for your time. It's been an absolute pleasure speaking to you this morning. Thank you so much.